Hey everyone, this is Chris with Combo, and I'm here with the Wileyfox Swift 2 Plus. So if you don't know them, Wileyfox, they're a UK manufacturer, specialising in phones of course. They launched their first two phones last year, the Storm and the Swift, basically very affordable phones, started around the £120 mark, and the Wileyfox Swift 2 and 2 Plus have just been launched today. So the 2 Plus is a slight update over the 2, slightly complicated, but we'll get to all that in a minute. But basically what you need to know about the Swift 2 Plus is that it costs from £189 here in the UK, but packs some pretty decent features to rival the likes of the Moto G4 Plus. So we're gonna have a quick prize open of this deliciously gorgeous orange box and have a bit of a squint at the contents. So first of all, let's just peel back this little sticker and see what we get inside. So last year's Swift, we actually got that here with us as well. It was a decent little phone, runs for Cyanogen rather than your standard Android and all the rest. Packs some sort of decent specs, but it wasn't quite perfect. So hopefully the 2 will and the 2 Plus will be able to rectify some of those little issues. So here is the Swift 2 Plus. So let's just peel back the random little sheaths and there you go. So first difference is, you can see this is last year's Swift. The Swift 2 and the Swift 2 Plus both have a deliciously gorgeous metallic frame now. I've used deliciously gorgeous twice now, I don't know why. Clearly I'm just hungry. So as you can see, nice and sturdy and give that a good smacking about. Looks sort of, yeah, like a decent sort of mid-ranger HTC and all the rest of it. As you can see, you've got a fingerprint sensor there on the back. You've got a 16 megapixel camera here on the Plus model, dual tone LED flash. More little stickers, let's get rid of that. We don't like stickers. Ah, there we go. And a little bit of Wileyfox branding, both the name of the logo there and the actual logo head, which as you can see is a lovely little fox. Very nice indeed. And if we whiz around to the front, we'll just see if there's any power in it. There is indeed some power, so we'll be able to set it all up and everything as well. You can see the home button, that might be the home button, otherwise it might just be another logo. We'll find out soon enough. The fox's head. And you've also got the front facing camera and everything as well. Up there at the top, that's an 8 megapixel camera. Quite a chunky little mobile, but definitely feels nice and solid and rugged. Liking it so far. It's definitely got a good heft to it. As you can see there, full Cyanogen running on it as well. So as I said, compared to the other models, it's lost this sort of soft touch plasticky feel. And also now it looks like you can't prise up in the back like you could with the old Swift. Now you've got the old SIM tray there instead with your, should also have a micro SD memory card slot in it as well. Besides that, quite similar in build, it's another 5-inch phone. Both the Swift 2 and the Swift 2 Plus are 5 inches. And once again, it's a 720p screen as well. So no difference there, but some of the other specs and the cameras have changed. So we'll run through all that. First, right, so we've whizzed through the quick network setup and everything. Sadly, it doesn't support 5 GHz Wi-Fi networks. We just connected to the bog standard 2.4. But we've also set up my Cyanogen count and all that stuff, logged in with my details, and now we're setting up the fingerprint sensor here on the back. So again, it's just Android standard fingerprint sensor setup, nice and Swift, and hopefully that should do the job nicely. So we'll give that a full testing out to see see if that actually does the job nicely. So yeah, we're in London, current time is 2:42. Right, okay, so while that's finishing setting up, we'll just take a look at the rest of the box. So as you can see, of course, you get all the usual manuals and fun stuff buried away in there, warranty guides and all the rest. And the only other thing in the box, nice and simple, is the USB cable for charging. As you can see, it's a Type-C USB, because this is now a Type-C device, unlike the old school USB on the original Swift. And again, you're not going to lose that cable anywhere, are you? Nice and orange, lovely. You probably see that one even when it's pitch black. So that's the contents of the box, nice and simple and straightforward. And now, as you can see, we are ready to play with the Swift 2 Plus. So as I said, full Cyanogen OS running on it. You now get a Snapdragon 430 compared to the 410 that was in last year's model. Last year's model was a little bit stuttery here and there, so kind of hoping that the 430, while not exactly a massive upgrade, will actually cope all right with Cyanogen. You get 3 GB of RAM in the Swift 2 model, but if you go, the Swift 2 Plus model, but if you go for the standard Swift 2, you just get 2 GB, so there might be a performance difference there. But as you can see, Cyanogen looks and feels very familiar. If you dive into the settings, you can get all the usual customization and all the rest. So you can do lots of stuff in the display side of things, live display, you get it to do sort of blue filter mode and all the rest of it, double tap to sleep. and all the rest, waking on plug once you plug it in. So yeah, so there's loads of little customization options, and of course you get the full themes which you can play around with as well. So this just allows you basically to pick and choose the best parts of each theme that you've played around with to use and combine them into one for you for basically your perfect theme. So again, you get the Wileyfox sort of branding coming through, so like the little fox head logo there for the home button. This indeed is not a button, it is just another logo, so you've got plenty of Wileyfox branding on this bad boy. You're not going to forget who's made this phone, that's for sure. But of course that's just part of the Wileyfox theme, so you could remove that and replace it with a different icon if you want to. Let's just do a quick fingerprint sensor test to see how fast and accurate it is. So just tap the old finger against the sensor now. And there we go, so it's reasonably fast. It recognized it first time as well. Just tap it again. Yeah, so there's a bit of a delay there. It's not quite as nippy as the likes of the Moto G4, the OnePlus 3 and all the rest of it. But to be fair, it does seem to recognize print first time. Just try it with the other print as well. Oh, didn't recognize it that time. There you go, second time lucky. So yeah, seems to be so far pretty accurate and sort of fairly responsive as well. So not too shabby considering the price of this handset. So yeah, what else is there to say about this phone? So it's a 16 megapixel camera in this Plus model, otherwise you get a 13 megapixel camera in the standard model. Let's just pull down good old BB-8 and he can be our model for a quick bit of photography. So here we go. So as you can see, it's a nice simple camera interface, as you would expect. You can once again manually focus with a quick tap, otherwise you get full autofocus on there as well. And once you focus, just hit the shutter button, take a quick step. And as you see, if you hold it down, we should be able to get a burst mode on the go. Although that doesn't really seem to be doing anything. Seems to be just taking a single shot still. Got hyperlapse panorama mode. So a nice, simple, streamlined interface, that's for sure. If you dive into the settings, should be able to see that you can shoot up to 1080p video as well. And you can, of course, obviously fiddle around with the aspect ratio and the rest of it. So yes, that's the camera. The video, as you can see, maximum size 1080p. You can also scale it down to 720p and the rest. You've also got high speed and slow motion, so you can shoot at 60 frames per second, which is nice, and all the rest. And then if we skip along to general, just little bits on the actual controls itself, how to take photos and all the rest. And as you can see, you can also skip to the front facing camera. Oh my God. Yeah, that's a bit bright. Sorry with all the those studio lights and everything, slightly fierce to say the least. But again, very simple streamlined interface, and you just take a quick snap like so. And if we dive into the results, oh, can't do it that way, I have to flip. Oh yeah, there we go. Might want to move your thumb next time, dickhead, well done. But yeah, I mean, hopefully the results should be fairly sort of detailed. Yeah, I mean, it looks like there's a good bit of detail coming through there. It is a 16 megapixel camera, so that's what you would expect. Hopefully it should look good on the big screen and hopefully cope well with a wide range of conditions. Certainly the Moto G4, which costs very similar to this, it had a very capable camera that was great in a wide range of conditions. And I'm just gonna turn that off right now because no, I'm not gonna take a video. No, stop, what am I doing? Sorry, I didn't get much sleep last night, so apologies if none of this video makes sense. It's also a 2700 milliamp battery in both the Swift 2 and the Swift 2 Plus, which supports quick charge 3.0, so hopefully it should charge up nice and fast. And besides that, there's not a massive amount else to say. So certainly if you've got last year's Swift, it looks like there's quite a lot of reasons to upgrade. You've got the likes of the fingerprint sensor, the faster performance, the updated camera and the rest. So it looks like it could be a solid Moto G4 rival. As I say, this model is available £189. You can pre-order in Amazon from today, and it should be available next week. You can also get the standard Swift 2 model, which has the pared-down camera and slightly less memory and storage for £159. So the choice is yours. So we'll be doing full features and reviews and all the rest of the Swift 2 Plus, and hopefully the Swift 2 as well at some point. So if you've got any questions, let us know, and thanks for watching. Cheers. And also, I'm sorry, but how freaking cute is this USB key? This wins USB Key of the Year award right now. Give up everyone else. Best ever.